Hi everyone, in this tutorial we are going to work with Python strings.
Let's watch this amazing video.
In before tutorial we seen about conditional statements, like it's like a very clear explanation, like having if else and if else if nested if, which was explained very clearly in before tutorial, and also I given some of the tasks which related to conditional statement. I hope everyone was enjoyed while doing that task, and also don't sit idle, because if you see these tutorials like continuously, nothing useless, because just open your laptop and install any notepad, not only Jupyter, just install any notepad and just practice, just do some tasks, then only you can learn any programming language, not only Python. I'm giving suggestion for any programming language. Okay, I hope everyone enjoying these tutorials. Almost 10 plus tutorials I made up to now. It's like a long journey, so I'm going to do more and more tutorials related to Python. Just stay tuned and subscribe to this channel for more updates. And now we'll go to today's tutorial. Just I'll close this conditional statements. Today we are going to discuss about strings. Just I'll create a new Python file which is strings, and in these strings also I'm going to give task, which is very crazy task that helps to your career. So okay, what is meant by string generally? So we'll always hear about string. String means the sequence of characters. The group of characters can be called as a string. What we are writing, everything can called as a string. You can see, like just I'm writing, this can be called as a string. Otherwise I'm writing, this can be called as a string. So everything what I'm writing, everything can called as a string. So okay, this is all about string. Now I want to print this string. Just I'm writing that name equal to Haripriya. Just I'm assigning variable and I'll like print name. So now we'll see that what happens. Just I'll print here, and you can see that I got an error, because just you can see that I got an error, which is Haripriya is not defined. Why it was not defined? Why it was getting an error? Because I kept like, okay, I written like only Haripriya. I'm not given any quotations or whatever it may be. Why? Because why string is enclosed with quotations? Why should we use quotations? I already said the group of characters, it should be into singular, right? That's why we should use quotations. Okay, how many types of quotations are there in your laptop? Just you can see the keyboard, we are having single quotes and double quotes, right? So which quote we should use? So which quote? So suppose I'll try like single quote. What happens? You can see that now I'll write like single quote. So just now I'll print, you can see I printed like Haripriya. So okay, single quote also it was printed. You can write double quotes, what you can see that. So double quotes is also printed. So now I'll write like triple quotes. What we can see that triple quote means just give like this three quotes, you can see. So this is called single quote, double quote, triple quote. So the string can be assigned like either single quote, double quote and triple quote, and we are having like other. So triple quote, which is like you can write double quotes quotations also. So just I'll show you how it was working. So instead of writing single quote, you can write like double quote. You can see the output. So yes, so you can write, so this is called triple quote, which with the double quotes. So this is the way to use, you can print this string by using single quote, double quote, triple quote, and also by using triple quote, by using double quotes. So you can use multiple ways, and you can also see the data type which is there. So just I'll give the data type. So yes, of course it is string. So for this one also, which is string. So this is the way to assign string. So no need to worry if you return that single quote or double quote also. I think, I hope everyone was understand how to write the quotations of the string. Suppose I want to print like I don't have my pen. So I don't have laptop. So just I want to print I don't have laptop. So I'm taking the variable name. So just reason, and I'm writing that I don't. So I don't have laptop. So just I'll print like I don't. You can see how it was working. So print reason. Yeah, I'm getting this invalid syntax, which is I'm not able to print anything. So why? Because I don't, I use like this. Instead of that, just you can use like this. Still we are getting the error, which I don't. Suppose generally we'll use I don't means apostrophe, right? So in this time, the single quote will not work, just observe. So in that time, just I'll write like double quote, which we are giving. So just make commands and write same thing which is in double quotes. Run. Yes, of course it's working. Because we given the single quote and single quote. Oh, just I'll write the triple quotes. How it was working, you can see that. You can see I'm writing the triple quotes. Just print reason. You can use double quotes, you can use triple quotes, but you can't use like single quote like this. We'll get a syntactical error. I hope everyone was understand about quotations, how to keep quotes in string. So now we are having like in Python, we are having like slash, like backslash and single quotes and double quote slash, and we are having like slash a slash b slash n. So these all things we are having in Python. Just see, and you can see that just I written something which is called, if you write like slash, it is called like a new line. If you like double slash, which is called as a backslash. So these all things was there. So just refer this one. I'm already pasting the document in description. You can find which is very clear that it's having some things which is called, generally we heard about slash and which is called new line in C. Like this only we are having like so many things which was there in Python. Just check. Now I want to write in backslash how we can print. So actually I am not able to print this one, right? That is reason I don't. So if we use backslash how it was working, we can see that. Now instead of writing this one, I'll use just backslash. Just I'll make like backslash. So how it was working, we can see. Just print reason. Just come, you can see that it was working fine because I kept like a slash backslash. So we can see that backslash is for a single quote. So it's like a backslash with single quote, we can call as, it's like a slash means take automatically as a string. So this is the way to write and uses, and I'm writing multiple strings also, multiple names, that is first line, second line, third line. So how we can use the multiple string? So just I'm using multiple strings. So while you are creating the variable, we should not give the space. Instead of giving the space, you should give like underscore wording instead of that first line and second line, third line, like fourth line. So I written like multiple strings. Just now I'll print this one. How it was printing, you can see that. Shift enter. You can see everything was printed with new line, right? Because I just given. So if I given like this, you can observe how it was working. So if you give in new line, automatically it's print in new line. If you give in the same line, it's print in same line. So based on your giving, it's print. And if you want to print, so it's take like slash n. So just I'll print like multiple string. You can observe that it's printing that slash n. It's separated by everything was slash n. That is called new line. So slash n here we are calling as new line. You can see we are having like line feed. So which is called as new line it was taking. So this is the way to print multiple string in new lines. And also if you want to print like tab space, just it is called slash t. So yeah, I'll write like tab space. So just I'm writing something which is called hurry. So and also I'm giving slash n and slash t. You can see the difference and hurry. So now I'm giving slash t for tabs. I'm printing hurry hurry in this time, and just print your tab space. You can see the output, just observe. This is hurry I printed, and I given slash n which is called new line, that's why it's taken new line, and I given that slash t which is called tab space. So this is the usage of print multiple things. If you want space, if you want new line, so these all the shortcuts. If you want to print like new line instead of slash and just give like enter, and you can see that it was printing in a new line. So instead of that, you need to give like triple quotes, then only it's take. Just you can see that, yes. So you need to give triple quotes if you want, like instead of writing slash n, you need to give like triple quotes. I think the quotations were very clear. So this is the way to print quotations of string. And also, if you write quotations in integers, floating values, or characters, boolean values, everything can be taken as a string. I already explained in variables concept, but now you will give like a try how it was working. So just I'll print like h, just I given the single value. So which is, you can see, is it string or not? Just I'll make it as type, which is string. We all of us know, of course, I given it is in quotations. Of course, we all of us know it is a string. Now I'll give like tree, which is in quotations. Now you can see the type. So type of tree, of course, it is also string. So if you make like single quotations, how it was working, we can see that. So instead of giving double quotations, just give single quotations. See, of course, it is a string. So now we'll take like floating values and we can check is it string or not. So I'm giving like floating values like 39.765. So just give 39.765. 765, just you can see it is a string, but it's generally it is a floating, right? So if you given any value, it is can take quotations, that can call as a string in Python. Just observe. So now again, just print, I'm writing like a true, which is, we all of us know that true is a boolean, right? So now we'll check that type of true, it is a string. So generally h is a string, but it is integer, float, and a boolean. So everything which was written in single quote or double quote, whatever it may be, it's taken as a string. I hope everyone was enjoyed about strings concepts. It is very clear. So I'll come with another tutorial that is about string slicing, how to slice the strings. If you're not still subscribed to my channel, just hit that subscribe button. Really, I want to do more tutorials on Python.
I hope this video is helpful to you. Definitely, I'll do more videos and more things, and let's subscribe this channel because if you support me, I'll do more and more videos. And do like and share also. And if you want to ask